So a first step in having a respectful, inclusive environment is to make sure that you're getting people's names right and also their pronouns correct. And somebody's name and their pronoun, it might be different than their legal name, and it might also be different than the pronoun that we assume to be correct. Using a correct pronoun in a preferred name is a really easy way to show that you see somebody and you value them as an individual. Gender identity and gender expression are a personal choice, and sometimes the pronouns that we were assigned at birth, they don't fit as we get older. Today, somebody might be choosing a pronoun that does fit their biological sex, or they might be choosing a pronoun that actually fits who they really are. If you're uncertain about the difference between sex and gender identity, and you've got questions about gender-inclusive pronouns, you might want to start by checking out this article, CIRC, Sex and Gender. It explains that sex refers to genetic differences, and gender identity is about cultural ideas about masculinity and femininity. Some of you might also be thinking, it's just a pronoun, what's the big deal? But it really is a big deal, and it's important to see and respect and value everybody in the room. To get a better understanding of why this matters, you might want to watch Ask Me, what LGBTQ students want their professors to know. It isn't an American video, but it is a really great example, and it has the voices and explains what some of the barriers and what some of the challenges are that our LGBT2SQ+ students may be facing in classrooms and in the community as a whole. Recent changes to MyACC has made it really easy for people to include their personal pronoun on a class roster list. But you have to actually go into MyACC to do this. It's really quite easy. I'll show you how. So under MyACC, you click on User Profile. It's going to open up the screen about you. You can click on Edit Personal Identity. And you can pull it down and you have a choice of she, her, hers, he, him, his, they, them, their, use my name as my pronoun, or ask me about my pronouns. Now, once a person adds this information into MyACC, it will show up on your class roster list, so your instructors will see that. And so you can expect if you put down ask me about my pronouns, that an instructor is going to come up to you and say privately, like, can you please tell me what pronoun you'd like us to use? Because this by no means is an exhaustive list. Now, even if you have pronouns that fit the stereotype of masculine or feminine, you still might want to go in and click your pronoun and save it, because what's going to end up happening at ACC is that across all of our platforms, so in Moodle and in our email, it's going to show your name and then it's going to show your pronoun in brackets behind it. So in mine, you're going to see Pam Roberts, she, her, hers. Why might you want to do that? One, it makes people aware of what your pronoun is so that people aren't making assumptions. And secondly, it signals to people that you're aware that different pronouns exist. And so it can make it so that you are a safe person, so somebody can say to you, hey, you know what? I would really rather you use they, them, their. Another thing that you might need to do is to adjust your preferred name. Because there's legal names and preferred names, this is something that you will need to contact registration, the registrar's office, to do. You can just give them an email and they will then update the information accordingly as to whether or not this change should be made only on your class roster list or if this should be changed on legal documents as well. So this might be a first step to participating in a respectful college. Thanks.